Welcome back to another video. Today what I'm going to be doing is installing these LED lights in my trunk here. So you got the halogens, and then also these are supposed to fit the license plate lights. So I'm going to go ahead and install these later tonight after I get some video of the halogens in the dark and at night on the license plate and the trunk. And then I'm going to put these in, and then you'll see the before and after. So these were only like 15 bucks Canadian, so that's like 10 bucks US or like 12 bucks US. So I'll put the link in the description below. But anyways, so yeah, I'll pick up this video later tonight. And also, I'm not sure if in the third gen, the dome lights are LED, but they come, I'm pretty sure these are LED. They're super bright. So don't mind the mess, but yeah, they already have LEDs in the dome lights. So it says it's for the domes, but I'm just not gonna switch out the dome lights because these are good enough. I wish these little blue lights were brighter though. I mean, it's kind of cool, like if you shut off the light, you get like this little blue glare on your shift knob. So I am still gonna get the lights that go under there, and I want the Acura cup holder lights. All right, so that is the before. So at night, it's one side. Looks way better. And yes, that's toilet paper. These are the license plate lights. As you can see, they're kind of getting burnt out anyways. These are the LEDs. All you need is a flathead and a 10 mil to get to the license plate, because you gotta take off the license plate bolts to get the plastic covering out. So I'm gonna go to the back of the car and show you how to do that right quick. This is my license plate, Mega Dog. That's a Roth. Meet a few my dogs. Free advertisement. Anyways, so all you do, there's a little notch and you just pull down. Oh shit. So yeah, you just pull down, you just pop it out, and it's that simple. And then pop it back in. Now you need to take off your 10 mils, which are behind here, to pull that plastic piece down. And then you just pull out the stock halogens and plug the LEDs back in. So I didn't make a detailed install because it's pretty self-explanatory and it was dark last night. Now for the trunk, on the other hand, same thing, super easy. Just boom. Oh, okay. I didn't do that yesterday. But anyways, so this one's a little more difficult. Jeez, I don't have the GoPro. It's pouring rain. My camera angle sucks. Anyways, let's try this. So these, there. So you pop the side, you just pop the side tabs on these ones. But as you can see, I have no idea how the LED fits in that one, to be honest. So I don't know if it'll work. So I'm not gonna put the LEDs in there, unfortunately. So really, I could only fit it in the license plate, but I'm assuming it's the same for the Accord. So I'm gonna put the LEDs on the girlfriend's Accord and maybe some LEDs in her dome lights and get my 12 bucks or 15 bucks worth out of the LEDs instead of just for the plates. Before. So yeah, I'm gonna dim out the plate in this video. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see the light, but you'll get the idea. With my puddle lights, I'll show you the other one, how burnt out it is. That's what that one looks like.
next are the switchbacks. I'm going with LED, and I'd like to get the blinkers too, but we'll start with the switchbacks. LEDs clear, because I got the fog lights, and they are super bright. But, yep, so that's that.
I went with blue, and you guys will see why I went with blue eventually.
But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will have a lot more coming.